Hello everyone. In the previous sessions, we know that the software-defined network is viewed as a leading technology of future network. The core idea of SDN is to decouple the control plane and the data plane, which enables centralized, flexible, and programmable network controller. The separation of control plane from the data plane makes software-defined network a controller-specific network. It monitors and manages all the data flows through the network. SDN network has undergone robustness and scalability tests as its growth rapidly in the networking sector. The scalability of any network depends on few major parameters. They are the way or method in which the network is connected, the network traffic, the controller placement, and the load balancing capabilities of the controller. Placing controller over the huge network is one of the major challenges in SDN. The networks like data centers have benefited from SDN, but it is still a problem to deploy SDN in wide area network or large scale networks. As we have already seen, the three layer architecture of SDN. The three layers are infrastructure layer, control layer, and application layer. Infrastructure layer consists of various SDN networking devices. The SDN networking devices control the forwarding and data processing capabilities of the network. This includes forwarding and processing of the data path. Control layer is the land of control plane where intelligent logic in SDN controllers would reside to control network infrastructure. Control layer lies in middle and it exposes two types of interfaces, northbound interface and southbound interface. Application layer, an open area to develop as much innovative as possible. As a SDN application provides various end-to-end solutions for real-world enterprises and data center network. Application layer, an open area to develop as much innovative application as possible. SDN application provides various end-to-end solutions for real-world enterprises and data center network. Before placing a controller over the network, various factors has to be considered. They are, how many controllers are required to cover the network? What is the best placement position for each SDN controller? What should be the capacity of each controller and how to manage multiple SDN controllers in the same network? There are two categories of controller in the SDN control plane. One is single controller and next one is the multi-controller. In the initial stage of SDN design, single controller manages the entire network. Let us assume that we have one controller C1 and four switches S1 to S4. So the one controller C1 manages the four switches in the network. When the source host sends a new packet to the switch S1, the switch cannot achieve the forwarding function due to the lack of routing information of the new packet. Then the switch S1 sends packet in messages to the controller C1 to get the routing for the new packet. So after getting the response message from the controller, the switch forwards the packet to the next device. So finally, the packet reaches the destination host successfully. Here the controller plays a major role in the process of traffic transmission. Unfortunately, as the network traffic increases fast, one single controller cannot deal with a large number of flow requests sent from switches because of the limited controller capacity. Meanwhile, once a single controller fails, the switches cannot plan the routing for the newly arrived packet, which affects the communication and the applications of the network. The multi-controller architect is the set of controllers working together to achieve some level of performance and scalability. In a multi-controller architect, controller can be placed in the network either centralized or distributed. That is, the controller can be placed physically centralized or physically distributed. When SDN appeared, the main tendency is to have a physically centralized controller. However, due to some issues like the single point of failure and the scalability problem, network experts suggest physically distributed design. It is important to understand that we are talking about a multi-controller architecture just in the case of physically distributed network. Physically distributed network can differ at various levels, like how to place the controllers and also which type of communications to use among them. A physically distributed architecture can be either logically centralized or logically distributed. Logically centralized means that we take advantages of the concept concept of multi-controller design, but at the same time we always consider that we have a single controller. In other words, we take the charge and we distribute it among the multiple controllers. However, for the underlying layer, it is like there is just one controller that commands the whole network, where the logically centralized architecture stays near to the initial tendency of the SDN, which is using a single controller or a multi-core controller to improve the performance. On the other hand, logically distributed architecture goes away from the first tendency of SDN by making several controllers have several responsibilities inside the network. In a logically distributed architecture, the controllers are physically and logically distributed. Additionally, every controller has just a view of the domain it is responsible for, and it can take decisions for it. Unlike the logically centralized design, where each controller makes decisions based on the global network view. One of the greatest advantages of SDN is that the network intelligence is centralized in the software-based controllers. The implementation of SDN using a single physical controller lead to the issues of scalability due to the limited resources of the SDN controller who handling a large number of requests, and robustness because as it is a single point of failure. A physically distributed but logically centralized SDN controller architecture promises to resolve both these issues. The general idea behind the deployment of multiple controllers is to distribute the load in the network equally. Further, one controller would take over when another crashes, thus solving both the issues of scalability and the robustness. Distributed SDN, along with its benefits, brings along the problem of the number of controllers required and their placement in the network. This problem is referred to as controller placement problem. The placement of controller depends on the type of the network. The network can be either local area network or wide area network. For the local area network LAN, the controller placement problem is simple. In general, only one controller is adequate to work in most LAN because a LAN is less affected by the propagation delay when compared to the wide area network. However, a WAN is normally categorized by long propagation delay and limited bandwidth. One of the most urgent challenges in deploying SDN in WAN is the controller placement problem. For example, in this picture, in LAN, we have two controllers, C1 and C2, and four switches. The issue is, where should controller C1 and C2 are placed in the WAN and the open flow switches? For example, in this picture, in WAN, we have two controllers, C1 and C2, and four switches. The issue is, where should controllers C1 and C2 are placed in WAN, and which controller C1 or C2 should be selected by the open flow switch S1. There are still open questions and have attracted much attention recently. The mapping between the switch and the controller is configured dynamically. The dynamic allocation can improve the scalability and the reliability of the SDN deployed in a LAN, but it is not suitable for the WAN. Usually, the propagation delay is larger than the queuing delay in the network, and the dynamic mapping between the switch and the remote controller will significantly affect the response time of the WAN. Moreover, switch migrations also are complex tasks with more overhead. We can treat WAN as a multiple SDN domains. To partition the WAN into several SDN domains by using spectral clustering partition, a single controller can be enough to manage small network, and the backup controller can reduce the impact of failure of the single controller. There are four reasons why we adopt divide and conquer philosophy. It facilitates load balancing and ensures reliability in the SDN infrastructure. The partition of SDN domains can reduce inter-controller broadcast storm, especially in large-scale WAN. There are no latencies in reassigning nodes to their new controller because of static allocation. It fits the layered model of the WAN and can easily for maintenance and expansion. In contrast, an overcomplicated control plane is hard to achieve and maintain. The controller placement influences every aspect of the SDN network in WAN, from performance to security. The two factors are balanced partition and propagation delay. Load balancing and reliability are two important indicators of SDN controller. With enough delay and overload of the controller, real-time tasks become infeasible, while others may slow down unacceptably. By partitioning the WAN into several small balanced SDN domains, the service ability of the controller with fewer and balanced nodes will be improved greatly, and the inter-controller broadcast storm will be reduced sharply, which will greatly reduce the queuing delay. The next is propagation latency. After considering the reliability of partitioning, network latency is certainly a significant design metric in long propagation delay WAN. Network latency include four parts: propagation latency, processing latency, queuing latency, and transmission latency. Let us come to end of today's session. In this session, we have focused on controller placement problem, as controller is the core component of the SDN architecture. Controller manages the application layer and infrastructure layer under different circumstances like LAN, WAN, or centralized and distributed environment. Various factors like scalability, robustness, balanced partition, or latency have been focused, and currently various research is going on controller placement problem. Thank you.